Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creatin Process. In today's video, we'll look at how you can create some amazing text effect using transform option in Adobe Illustrator. In this tutorial, we'll understand how you can use transform option attributes to create out these amazing texts using very simple techniques. So in the previous video, we have seen how you can create some amazing text effect using replay spline option in Adobe Illustrator. We have created this design to understand the concept of replay spline option, and after that we have applied the same concept and created out these two amazing text designs. In this tutorial, we'll understand how you can create out these three amazing text design using transform option. So we'll apply the transform option to the first design and understand how you can apply it to any design, and after that we'll apply the same concept and create this nice text design. Also, we'll understand how you can apply gradient to your strokes or outline using appearance option. And lastly, we'll create this nice perspective text effect using the same tools, that's transform option and a shear transform option. So let's begin with the designing process. So let's create out this first design. So I'll create out, select text tool and type out TYP type, and let's change the color to something white and scale it down around this much and place it in the center, something like that. Now, as you can see over here, we have designed this text using three layers. First one is our main, simple, and second is this top, and third is this one layer. So using these three designs, I have combined together and created out this effect. So let's create this. So I'll just select this and I'll create a duplicate of it and place it aside just to use it for later on. So now let's remove the fill color. So I'll just remove this fill color. Now, as you can see, there's no fill color as well as there's no stroke color. So we're gonna apply stroke and fill color using appearance panel. So go to appearance, and if you don't find it over here, you can go to windows and just click on appearance and it will be there. So under appearance panel, we're gonna apply add stroke. So we're gonna need a stroke to this text. So, and I'm gonna change the stroke color to white. Now we got a stroke color. Now let's increase the stroke thickness to around 2 points. And here we go. We got a nice text here with a outline here. And what I'll do is I'll just add a gradient color to this. So let's add a gradient. So let's go over here and choose a gradient color, something like that. So now to apply it, you have to first select the text, right? And then go to color and choose gradient, and here we go, we got a nice gradient. Now to edit the gradient color, double click OK, and this will open this gradient attribute panel here. Let's slide this over here and over here, and let's change the angle. So if you change the angle over here, you can see you can rotate the direction of the gradient. So what we need over here is this one, we need a top portion, so something like that. And I'll just place it somewhere around here just to see the top region like this. Okay. And I'll just change the down color to black so that it's not visible. So what I'll do is I'll just select this and using the eyedropper tool, just click on the background color, and here we go, we got that nice one. And now we need to duplicate, create a copy of three. So to increase the number of copies, what we'll do is we'll go to effect, and now we'll add transform. So we'll go to effect distort and click on transform option, and this will open this transform attribute panel here. Let's increase the copy, let's say one or two, and here we'll need to move it. So you can either move it horizontally or vertically. So if you move it horizontally, you can see it will move sideways. So what I need is I want it in a top or bottom. So I'll just push it up, something like that, vertically, and like that. And over here, you got some scaling value. You can scale it horizontally or you can scale it vertical. So for this design, what I need is I need it to be scaled horizontally. So I'll just scale it horizontally, and this should be 100%. This is the base value. And here, let's scale it a little bit, something like that. Okay, and I'll click. Okay, so here we go. We got three duplicates in here. And in the same way, I'll create another duplicate of this. So with the OPRESS, click and drag it down. Select, click and drag it down with the OPRESS. And after creating a duplicate of it, go to Appearance. And under Appearance, you'll find the Transform option over here. Double click on it to open the Transform option panel. And here, instead of 20 points, what I'll do is plus 20 points like this. Okay, something like that. And 20 points. Okay, And now I'll just click OK. And after that, we'll change the gradient direction. So select the stroke, right? Or select the text and double click on the gradient tool. And this will open a gradient panel. And here, let's change the angle to 90 degree. Earlier it was 90 degree minus 90 degree. Now we'll change it to 90 degree and enter. And here we go. We got a nice bottom shade over here. Something like this. And it's looking great. You can do the adjustments anytime. Like if you want to decrease the value of black, just make it slide this side just to increase the surface area over there. And here we go. And now after that, what I'll do is I'll just bring this text around here. Okay, and place it carefully there. And this one, I'll just drag it down with the shift pressed. Just drag it down and place it somewhere on here. And I can anytime go into the appearance, transform, and just increase the horizontal scale value. And this will help me like increase the gap between the alphabets and just to balance out the design. So I can anytime go in there, or I can increase the vertical gap like this. And okay, I'll just keep it that way. And in the same way, I can just select the top text as well, go to transform, and just increase the gap a little bit, and horizontal movement, something like that. And click OK. And here we go, we got that nice text design using very simple options. That's how we have used transform option to create this nice text design. So let's look at how we can create out these next design using the same tools. So what I'll do is I'll just type out text similarly, S-T-A-Y-S-T, right? And let's fill this up with white color. Okay, so I'll just choose white color, and I'll just scale this up a little bit, something like this. Okay, that's looking great. Now for this also, we need three duplicates, like this one, and this one. So I'll just create under duplicate for later on. And now let's remove the fill color. So I'll just select the fill color and remove it. And let's apply stroke color. And we're gonna apply stroke color from the appearance panel, not from here, because if you apply stroke color from this, you'll not be able to apply the gradient color. So what we need is we need to apply stroke color from appearance panel. So click on appearance. And as earlier, you can open it from Windows as well. Under appearance, let's just add a new stroke and change the stroke color to white. Okay, and let's increase the stroke thickness for this one around 3 points. Yes. And now we'll also increase the gap between the text. So what we can do over here is you can select your text, and you can anytime go into character. And under character, you have all these attributes over here. You can increase the size of the text. You can increase the gap between each of the alphabets, or overall scaling value is over here. And you can even like change the individual text angles. So I'll just keep it 0 and set the gap between each of the alphabets 75 and press enter. And that way I got this nicely balanced text over here. Now next thing I'm going to do is to create a duplicate, something like this. So it's the same technique. We'll apply transform option. So I'll go to effect, transform, and transform option. And under transform, we'll first create few duplicates. Let's say we need 3 duplicates. I'll just create 3 over here, just the value 3, and increase the vertical value, something like this. What we're doing over here is we need this vertical duplicates. You can either, if your design required something horizontal design, something you want to give something like this, or the other side, you can give it. But right now for this design, we need it in vertical direction. So I'll just increase the distance, something like this. And for this, we don't need to adjust the horizontal vertical scaling value. But if you want, you can just adjust the value something like this, or you can adjust the value something like this. So it's all according to your requirements. So for this design, we don't need to adjust the horizontal and vertical scale value. We just need the vertical movement value. And what else we need over here? We need this 3 copy, and this one we'll understand it in the next tutorial, where I'll talk about how you can use this rotate angle to create your own design. So for this tutorial, we will understand scale, move, and the copies, right? And once you are happy with this, I'll just click OK, and the number of copies has been applied. And now let's apply the gradient. And as you know, we can apply gradient to this very easily. Just I'll go to appearance, right? And over here, choose gradient. So if you have applied the stroke color from here, directly from this option here, you will not be able to get this gradient option. Under this stroke, if I go over here, you see that you can apply the gradient over here. But if by chance, let's say you have created a text, right? And you have applied a stroke color, right? That white. And now you want to apply gradient color. It's very difficult to apply. Over here, you can apply. So as you can see, you can't apply gradient to your normal stroke color. Like say, if you even increase the thickness and then you want to apply some simple gradient color, you can't. So the best thing to apply gradient color is just to remove all the color from here, right? And after that, selecting your text, go to appearance and add a stroke color. And this will, in this stroke, you can apply gradient very easily. So here, as you can see, when I apply, click on this color and choose gradient, it's automatically applied over here. And let's do the same adjustments. Double click on your gradient tool and just place it over here, just giving some gap, and let's rotate it. So 90 degree, let's try how it looks. Okay, we want it on top surface. We want white on the top. So let's give minus 90 degree, enter. And let's choose red color for this black side. So just selecting that slider, then using the eyedropper, just click the color and here we go. And you can just adjust the position of your gradient, something like this. Okay, and I think this looks great. Now the second design, that's the below one, I'll just create a duplicate of this with your press click and drag and down, something like that. And let's double click on this. Okay, command all or control all and just type alive. And now for this one, we'll again go to appearance, right? And this text already got this transform option, which we have applied because it's the same text, and under appearance, you'll find the transform option. Just click on it and we'll do some adjustments with the values. So as you can see, it's downward. So basically let's remove the minus value and yes, it's done. It's downward. Click OK. And we need to change the direction of the gradient. So we'll just double click on the gradient tool, right? And just change this minus 90 to 90 and enter, and here we go. And also let's try to keep it over here and let's see what else we need to change. And I think the direction is fine. We need to increase the gap in between the text, so that can be done under appearance and transform. So go to transform and increase the gap, right, something like that. Okay, and you can do the same for the upper text as well. Just go to transform and increase the gap a little bit. Okay, something like that, and it looks great. Now I'll just place this text in the center somewhere around here, and as you can see, this text, there is no gap in between the alphabet. So I'll just go to a character again and just set it to 75, as I have applied the same value for the other text as well. So I'll just place it somewhere around here and just place it around here, something like that. And this one, I'll just move around and place it. Let's try to select all of them, right, and place it in the center. And if you zoom it out, you can see it's the same design. So that's how we have used transform option and various other attributes such as scale, move and copies. Now the next thing, we're going to create out this text effect. So as you can see, it's quite a perspective look. It's not very hard to create. It's the same process. There is only one option which I have used, that's shear transform option, and that will give you this nice perspective look. So let's create this. So the same thing, type out your text, right? Just type out soul, s-e-o-u-l, soul, and I'll just fill this up with white color. And for this design, I have one background layer and the top layer, so it's just two layers. So let's create this. I'll just create a duplicate of this simply somewhere on here, right? And now to this, for this design we don't need gradient, right? We don't need anything. We just need a simple black and white strokes, right? So for this, you don't need to go to appearance and give a stroke color. So I'll just use the simple color over here. So first thing, let's remove the gaps between each of the alphabets. So I'll go to character and just give it around 10 points, right? Now let's give it a stroke color and fill it up with black color, something like that, or maybe a little grayish tone just to see this effect. So let's little give grayish tone, right, something like that. And we can increase the stroke thickness around here if you want to. And now let's apply transform. So I'll go to effect, transform, and under transform panel, what we can do is we'll first create a number of copies. So for this we need around 4 or 5 duplicates, 1 2 3 4 5. So let's add around 4 with the original one, and we need it to be slightly downward. So you will use the vertical displacement, vertical movement. Horizontal we don't need it right now, we need a vertical. So I'll just move it down. Let's see the gapping. We'll just adjust the gapping properly, and I think it looks great, and just click OK. So here we go. Now the next thing we're gonna do is to let's give this angular shear. So it's very simple, right click, transform, and shear transform, and here we go. So if your shear angle is 0, it's going to be default, so it will look something like this. Now if you give a shear angle, you can give it a angular perspective look, something like that, see, something like this. And you can just make it a little bit narrower or a little bit broader and angular. Okay, and click OK. So here we go. I'll just reduce the size a little bit and place it around here, and as you can see, it's looking very simple, very easy. And I can directly use this. I'll just create a duplicate of this for the top surface. I'll just create a duplicate of this, command control C, command control F, right? And I'll go to appearance and remove this transform, and after that just fill it up with simple plain color and remove the stroke, and here we go. And I'll just delete this out, and our perspective text using the transform option is created. Very easy, very simple, very easy. Let's say you want to edit it, so I'll go over here, appearance, and select this bottom one, transform, and I'll just reduce the spacing and 1 2 3 4 increase. You can increase it if you want, and you can click OK. Right click to open the shear angle, so select, right click, transform, shear, and just increase the angular, something similar, something like 20, and a little broader. Okay, and I'll do the same for this one as well. Arrange, transform, shear, 20 and 4, and click OK. So here we go. I'll just place it and scale it a little bit downward and place it in the center. So this is how we have created this nice text effect using transform option. During the process, we have understood how we can use a scale, a horizontal, vertical option. We have also used move horizontal, vertical, as well as we have used this to decide how many copies you want to give to your design. So in the next video, we'll create a few more amazing text designs and other shapes design using the transform options. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe this channel. Thank you.